A few weeks ago, developers started reporting major fluctuations in how they were ranking for certain keywords in the App Store. So what happened? Well, back in June, Apple updated the App Store ranking algorithm with the biggest update in a very long time. And to put it simply, App Store screenshots are a lot more important now, and the boost for brand new apps may be gone, or if not gone, severely diminished. Let's talk about what's going on and what you should do about it. This video is sponsored by AppScreens. It's a super easy way to generate these App Store screenshots with multiple devices and localizations, which are now going to play a much bigger role in this new App Store algorithm. There's a link in the description, but more on them later. Before we talk about these screenshots, let's talk about the App Store boost going away. First of all, if you're not familiar with this App Store boost, for the longest time, if you launched a brand new app, Apple would give it a pretty significant boost in the rankings for about the first week or so. That way, Apple could gather information, right? How many downloads it's getting, what's the conversion rate? I don't know all the information Apple was gathering, but it needs to gather some initial data so it knows how to rank the app. So to do that, it would get a nice artificial boost in the rankings, so the app would get some initial downloads, which was nice for us developers because you launch an app, you get that dopamine hit of new downloads. Even though it went away after 7 days, it was still nice. Well, that appears to be gone. I know I just launched an app about 2 weeks ago. I didn't experience it at all. For my app, and others have reported this as well, if I even typed in the exact name of my app, which was Formula Widgets Push Push, it's an F1 widgets app, the exact title match on something very specific didn't show up at all in the search. In fact, it took my app 13 days to start ranking for more than 2 keywords. And again, many other developers are reporting this as well. So what's going on? Now, keep in mind, Apple hasn't officially said anything about this. This is just us theorizing like what might be happening and why they might be doing this. And one obvious thing that makes a ton of sense is now with AI, you can build an app in like a day and get it up on the App Store. So I'm sure they're being flooded with all these new apps, and a lot of them are, you know, what we call AI slop. They're not great apps. So you're giving this artificial boost to so many apps and a much larger number of them as people are making more and more apps faster and faster and faster. It kind of makes sense that that 7-day boost isn't doing what it was originally intended to do. In fact, I even saw someone talking on Twitter or X about building a whole strategy around that. Because it's so fast to build an app, basically build a new app every 7 days with a very aggressive monetization strategy. So you're basically just milking that free boost. Now, again, I'm not saying that would have worked out, but people were having those ideas is what I'm trying to say. So it does make perfect sense with the, I'm sure, huge number of new AI slop apps coming on that the old 7-day boost was doing more harm than good probably. Now others, maybe more negatively, have said that, oh, this is going to push people towards Apple search ads, because that's what I had to do in order for me to get any downloads initially. Well, aside from me, like, I got an initial spike, but that's just because I have an audience and people just want to check out an app that I built, right? They're not really my customers, but that lasted like 2 days. And then I went back down to basically nothing. So the way I was getting downloads was, yeah, I had to pay Apple search ads. So the negative view on it is that Apple's trying to milk us for more money with Apple search ads. I think it has a lot more to do with all the AI slop being submitted and giving those apps boost. So I think it has more to do with that, but you know, I can see that angle too, nudging us towards more Apple search ads. So in the grand scheme of things, I actually think this is better. Like, yeah, it sucks not getting that initial boost. You have to do more of the work yourself with external marketing, whether that's TikTok, Twitter, YouTube, however you want to market outside of the App Store. I mean, you should be doing all that stuff anyway if you're trying to make money from your app, but now you're just kind of forced to do it from the start. But at the end of the day, we haven't seen the long-term effects of this. If over the long run, the better, more established apps that are getting users, that are getting good ratings, those rise to the top, I think that's better for the App Store in the long run. Now let's talk about the App Store screenshots and why they are very important now. And for that, let's go to Ariel from App Figures. If you're not familiar with App Figures, they've long been in the ASO game, App Store optimization, and much more than that now. Ariel's been the go-to expert for ASO for many, many, many years now. And the App Figures platform has tons of apps on it, tons of data. And Ariel went in for a few days, analyzed this data, tried to figure out what was going on, why were all these rankings changed? And his discovery, which he said was pretty conclusive, that's why he was willing to, you know, put his reputation on the line, put it out there, was that Apple is now extracting text from your app's screenshot captions and treating that text as part of your keyword metadata. That's right. Screenshots are no longer just for conversions. They now influence discovery. In the past, only your app's name, subtitle, and keyword list counted towards search rankings, but that's no longer the case. Apple now reads some of the visible text in your screenshots and uses those keywords to rank your apps. So what that means is Apple is now looking at your screenshots, whether AI or OCR, and pulling out relevant data to give it more information to better rank your app for appropriate keywords. So what should you do? Well, obviously, start putting some keywords in your App Store screenshots, but don't be silly, don't overdo it, don't stuff 100 keywords in your App Store screenshots. Like, Apple's smarter than that, they're not gonna fall for that one. But what you can do is eliminate passive keywords. You know, a lot of times people will use easy to use or all in one. Well, people aren't searching for that. Ariel uses the example of track sleep patterns. That is a keyword, sleep patterns, track sleep. And another example of what not to do, don't say wake up refreshed. That is now, I don't want to say a waste, but that is now probably not the wisest use of the screen real estate you have on your App Store screenshots. Another thing you want to do here, and gives a visual example, is increase the contrast. Make it easy for the machine, right, the OCR, the AI, whatever it is, to read your text. So if you have a glowing, shadowy, hard to read, crazy font, might not be the best idea. And if there's not a high contrast, that might not be the best idea either. So to sum it up, the words you use in your App Store screenshots should be relevant keywords and still make sense to the user, right? Because at the end of the day, the user has to look at your screenshot and want to download it. So don't just keyword stuff it so it makes no sense. But again, avoid the all-in-one, easy to use, things that are kind of irrelevant that don't really get the point across. Now, updating all your screenshots for this is probably gonna be a lot of work, especially if you have multiple devices like the iPhone, the iPad. Maybe you have 8 localizations. Like, that's a ton of work, unless you're using today's sponsor, AppScreens. AppScreens is a fast and easy way to create your App Store screenshots. To get started, you can use one of their many, many templates. You can use them as is, or you can use the template as a starting point and tweak it and customize it to match your brand. Or you can use AppScreens design tool and start completely from scratch and build your own App Store screenshots from the ground up. AppScreens can localize your screenshots into any supported language. It can support iPad, iPhone, Android devices. It can automatically upload to the App Store, Google Play Store. I mean, look, here's what I had to do before. Look at this giant sketch file with all the different iterations on my App Store screenshots for Mac, iPhone, iPad, and this app isn't even localized. Imagine if I had 7 different languages on top of this. This just becomes an absolute mess. And AppScreens is an amazing tool that handles all this for you, saving you so much time, especially as an indie dev. So check out AppScreens to update your App Store screenshots to take advantage of this new App Store algorithm where keywords and App Store screenshots play a huge role. Check them out. Link is in the description.